In this video, I'll give you an overview of the Task by Planner and To-Do app, which sits within Microsoft Teams. It was originally called the Planner app, but has recently been renamed. The task created can be found in the Teams app and in your Outlook, and it will soon correspond with Teams Mobile. So to find the app, you can use the More Added Apps, which is the three dots in your left toolbar. If you open this up, you can then just search for the Tasks application. Alternatively, you can also use the search bar at the very top. If you feel it's something you'll be using regularly, you can right-click on the app icon in the left toolbar and you can pin it. Then when you switch to other applications, the Tasks app will always stay in your left toolbar. So here I've set up some example tasks. At the very top of your task list, you'll see the option to add a task, and this is how you would add new ones. So if you click on here, it will change to enter a text field. And then let's just call this task 5. Along the columns, you can set a priority. So anything that's not high priority, you'd leave as medium, or you can set it as important. And then you can also set a due date. So when you click on the calendar, it will present a write-in option. But if you click on it again, you can then have the calendar pop up. Or you can also choose not to put a due date in at all. And then you can just click the tick to create the task or the cross if you want to cancel the creation. So the example tasks I've set up here, you can see that test task 1 has normal priority, as there's nothing showing here, and is due on the 15th. Test task 2 has a high priority and has a due date as well. And test task 3 has no priority and no due date. So if we look down the left, you can see there's 4 different options. So you've got important. So important will show you all the tasks that you've set as a high priority. Now when we go into important, you'll see that there's a new column called source, and the source for this one is tasks. And what that means is that this task has come from the tasks app itself. Other sources could include Teams, because you can add tasks onto your individual Teams, and I'll show you a bit more about that later. You then have planned, so planned will then show you any tasks that you have with a due date set, and it will automatically filter them in order of the due date. And again, you can see that source again there. And then assigned to me, so currently this is empty for me, but if you had a colleague who created a task list in a team, they can then assign tasks to you, and those lists will show in here. You also have the option to create a list here and a new list or plan here. So these will both bring up the same option. So if we just click one of these, so you can see you want to give your new list or your plan a name. So we'll just call this test list 1. And then creating is where you'll see the different options. So my task again is the task app. And then you'll have all of your team names down the side to select from as well. And then you can click create. And that will then create the test list in here. And you can start adding tasks. So this is a great way to group tasks by certain projects. Something to note on this. So when you create lists, you cannot delete this list within the Teams application. Okay, so as I mentioned earlier, Task by Planner and To Do does connect with your Outlook. So if we open up my Outlook now, you can see here are some of the test tasks and their due dates. So no date is the one that we set without a date. These are the ones that we sent with dates. So tomorrow and this month, it will group them for you. And the test list that we created shows here. So this is shown as a folder. So we didn't add any tasks into here. You can add tasks via Outlook as well, but we didn't add any tasks into this one. But this is where you would have to delete that list. So you simply would right click and then delete it as it's created as a folder. So that's just really important to remember. And then if you do delete something like that, when you go back into Teams, you'll need to click the 3 dots at the top right and then refresh the page. That might just take a couple minutes to update, and then that folder and that list is gone. So just as an extra note, in case you're unaware of how to find the task list in Outlook, so you've got this little toolbar at the bottom. So here you've got like your mail and your calendar, and you want to look for the little clipboard. If you don't see the clipboard, then you can click on the three dots and it might show up here as well. Okay, so we're going to go back to tasks, and then there's a couple more options on here. So when you complete a task, you can simply tick it here, which is great. That will remove it from your list. And at the top here, there's a couple of filters. So we've got all active. So you can either look at all your active tasks that are currently yet to be completed, or you can go into completed and it will show you any tasks that you have. You also have a filter button here, so you can just filter by the date. So is something late if you want to filter by it? Is it due today, tomorrow, this week, however you want to filter by? And you can also filter by importance, but obviously you do also have that importance tab here. But you could also filter by keywords, so if you were looking for specific tasks with specific words in, then you can search for that. At the end of each task, you've got another set of three dots, so you have your progress, so you can also tick it to be completed or not started in here. You can change the priority, you can change the due date, and you can also move tasks, and what that means is that you can just move it into another folder. And then you also have delete, so if you want to completely delete that task, then you can do that there. So the next thing I want to show you is adding a task list to a specific team. So here I'm currently in our marketing team. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the top and I'm going to click on the little plus, which is to add a tab. When I do this, it'll bring up a range of different apps. So I've recently accessed the task by planner, so that will appear at the top. But if you don't see it, you can use the search bar. So I'm going to click on there. So then the options will come up. So you can give the tab a name. So we can just call this marketing task list. If you do already have an existing plan from using the planner app, then you can import it. But we're just going to create a new one today. And you can also opt to post directly to the channel about this tab. So when the tab is created, it'll just post a message in the posts channel. And then we're going to hit save. So you can see it's now added it as a tab at the top of my team, which means that anyone in that team can access the task list. And there you go. So that's all loaded. So if you want to add a task, it'll give you the option straight away to do that. So let's just say add new insight to website. You can set a due date, so let's do that tomorrow, and then assign someone. So if I need to assign myself, and then we can add a task. And there you go, so that task has been added. Group by bucket at the top, so you can group your tasks by certain labels. So you have like assigned to, the progress, the due date. So if you were going to group them by assigned to, then you can see all my tasks would be down here. If we assign some tasks to someone else, they'd present themselves in columns. Or you can assign by progress. So you can see not started, in progress and completed. You've got due dates. So tomorrow, obviously, if we had more tasks, they would show up with more and things like that. And you can also create custom buckets yourself as well. Filter again is the same as on the task list. So you can filter by who it's assigned to, you can filter by buckets, labels, priorities, due dates, things like that. And then you have an option of like different ways to view your list. So you can just view it as one big list. And again, you've got the all active or completed and the filters still. The borders will all automatically come up, so that's where you can add your different buckets. You've also got charts, so you can see how many tasks you have left, how many in progress, late completed, what priority they are, who's assigned to the task, a good range of analytics that you can see. And then you've also got a schedule, so this would be good if you wanted to do content scheduling, so you can see a calendar and your tasks will appear on the date that they're due. So now that I've added that task list to my marketing team, I've gone back into the task by planner and to do application. And you can see if we go to assign by me, So I was assigned this task, and that's been listed under my assigned to me task list. And you can see that that source has changed to show that it came from the marketing task list. Now, I'm also part of the marketing team itself. And you can see that that's now appeared under my shared plans. So any tasks that are created in that marketing team, I can now view under here. You can see who they're assigned to. And you can do all the same features that you could within the team list itself. So you can set to boards, you can set to charts, you can set to schedule. So hopefully that gives you a good overview of the task by planner and to-do lists within Teams.